Now, to a rather interesting development, Kamala Harris supporters have referred to this book she wrote back in 2009 called Smart on Crime. This is when she was serving as a district attorney. They say this is evidence that she's not soft on crime, she gets it. But it's been revealed that numerous sections from that book appear to have been plagiarised. Chris Rufo, the man who exposed the plagiarism scandal at Harvard, President Claudine Gay has since stepped down. Well, he's published the allegations on X following an investigation by Austrian plagiarism hunter Stefan Weber. The cited passages, I've got to say, Josh, from the book, it's remarkable. Some of them closely resemble or perfectly match wording from other sources, including Wikipedia. Have a look at this example. She's copied the source almost exactly. There's the word additional has been added there. That's about it. How long before the leftist media covered this scandal? Because this is a genuine story, and I think a lot of them are scared to even approach it. Some of them are covering it as far as the Republicans reacting to the story as opposed to the story itself.
So first of all, credit to my friend Chris Rufo, who I've known for years, and he is one of by far the most effective conservative activists that we have here in America. Oh, yeah. He basically almost single-handedly took down Claudine Gay when she was president of Harvard for her own plagiarism scandals, and he's trying to do it again here with Kamala Harris. So fantastic work by Chris. Look, if there is any justice in the world, this would be a gargantuan story, because the evidence, as we just saw on the screen for all the viewers, is absolutely overwhelming. And, you know, some people say, oh, she was a public figure, she probably just had a ghostwriter. Guess what? I also ghost wrote a book for Senator Ted Cruz in 2020. Ghostwriting is overstating it. We worked very closely on it. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter who is helping you on it. It matters who actually publishes it under their own line. The buck stops with the person right there. And Kamala Harris is a plagiarizer. Kamala Harris, by the way, just like Joe Biden, who himself subsequently admitted to plagiarizing back when he was in law school, which he did. Kamala Harris has plagiarized large swaths here from no less a source than Wikipedia itself. Look, I remember when I was in high school, and they would literally tell me in research class in high school, do not cite Wikipedia. It is not an authoritative source. This woman wants to be leader of the free world, and she is going ahead and sloppily citing and, in many cases, actually misquoting the statistics from Wikipedia there. It is a gargantuan story. It cuts to the very core of the Republican case against Kamala Harris, namely that she is a dim-witted moron who is not fit to be local dog catcher, let alone to be commander in chief of the greatest military the world has ever seen. So I think it's a terrible story for her. Your question, of course, is the valid one. The media will do everything they can to sweep this under the rug. I'm not sure it's going to be the dispositive difference in this election, but it should make at least an impact. I think that Donald Trump is already winning this election, so certainly he's already in better shape because of this.
Josh Hammer, always a pleasure. Thanks for your time.
Thank you, Rita.